A decade ago, e-commerce solutions generally consisted of a static website and a simple checkout script. Today's customers demand a richer, more dynamic experience across a variety of devices. Today, I speak with Chris Langway of Optaros to learn more about their e-commerce solutions.
And since you'll be talking about e-commerce, Jeff, which often use databases, I'll be chatting with Pavan Padakuchi of Amazon RDS about scalability.
What do you do for Optaros?
I have the best job at Optaros. I'm an e-commerce business strategist, and so in that role, I get to work with our great clients as well as a cool bunch of prospects in understanding their business challenges and hearing their concerns, and then I get to come back, work with a bunch of really smart people at Optaros to help develop solutions to help accelerate their digital commerce activities.
Tell me a bit about what Optaros does.
Optaros is a professional services firm. We're, 100% focused on digital commerce. It's, basically all that we do. So in that capacity, we work very closely with clients to design, develop, increasingly actually host and support customers' e-commerce experiences on an ongoing basis. Those solutions tend to be typical B2C, B2B, and given, ubiquity of mobile, many of our solutions are obviously mobile-optimized websites or mobile applications.
Are there particular kinds of e-commerce experiences you try to build?
If you look at our client list, I think our roster of clients is probably as diverse as the e-commerce landscape is today. And there's some complex business models out there. We work with, web pure plays who are more digital disruptors who have some very interesting business models, not a typical buyer-seller relationship, but there may be a merchandiser or a stylist involved in the process. We work with multi-branded, multi-channel manufacturers who are dealing with issues such as omni-channel and how do you deliver a seamless experience across both brick and mortar and online. We work with branded manufacturers. So, they're challenged with, how do I balance brand and commerce? Or, how do I manage channel conflict with all of a sudden I'm now competing against my own customer? And, increasingly, we're also working with a number of clients who you wouldn't normally expect to see in commerce, right? Like pharmaceutical, for example, where we work with a number of companies to help them optimize some of their B2B experiences. So it really is quite diverse.
How do the cloud and AWS factor into what you do?
More and more, we're seeing that our clients are on the business side of the house versus IT. So they're the CMO. And, they're folks that want to focus on what they do best. And what they do best is product and marketing and merchandising. And so increasingly, they're coming to us to host and support their experiences on an ongoing basis. And that's really where AWS has come in and has been a tremendous partner for us. So by moving commerce to the cloud, our customers benefit from scalability. We work with clients that run event-based retail models where things can go from zero to here very quickly. And so to be able to auto-scale that through AWS is critical. Our clients also benefit from speed to market, right? So many of our clients feel like they're behind the times, they're trying to catch up, or they see an opportunity they need to leapfrog their competition. And so to be able to provision up an environment very quickly, get to work, enables us to do our job and please our clients.
Where would you see this going over the next, let's say, 6 to 18 months or so?
I think commerce in the cloud is still in the minority. I think that companies are getting more comfortable with moving some of their other applications to the cloud, but commerce has lagged behind a little bit still. I think if you look at the reports, there's going to be a lot of replatforming over the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years even. So your time frame was even a little shorter. But, I've read reports as well that say that 40 to 50% of those people considering replatforms are going to consider commerce in the cloud. And so I think you will see even the larger enterprises get more comfortable with moving their commerce experiences to the cloud.
I really appreciate your taking the time to come by and speak with us today and wish you guys all the best.
Hey, thanks, Jeff. Had fun.
I'm here with Pavan Padakuchi of the RDS team. Thanks for joining me today.
Thanks for inviting me.
Tell me about scalability with RDS.
So there are two different dimensions through which you can scale RDS. So the first one is vertical scaling, through which you can scale up your compute or memory capacity. And then the second category is horizontal scaling, through which you can scale your read traffic using read replicas.
Can you please tell me more about horizontal scaling?
So customers can create multiple read replicas corresponding to a master instance. So read replicas are asynchronous slaves of a master instance. And customers can spread their read traffic to the read replicas and serve their write traffic to the master instance. Mm-hmm. And then for read-heavy applications can get a lot of benefit through this mechanism.
So for an e-commerce customer, that might make sense for maybe like a large catalog?
Yeah, absolutely. For catalogs and things like that, which can be served through the read replicas, it's a very good use case.
Cool. Any other major use cases for this?
So there are a couple of other use cases, you know, in gaming and social networking. So if you have status updates, etc., it'll be good to serve them through read replicas. In mobile gaming, you have user metadata, etc. It can be served through read replicas.
And how many replicas could you have?
So about five. About five is what we support today for Master Instance.
Well, thank you so much for your time today. It was a pleasure chatting with you.
Thank you. Same here.
Thanks for watching AWS Report. I'm Jeff Barr. I'd love for you to connect with me online. You can follow me on Twitter, read my blog, and leave me a comment so I can know what you think.